Hey, what's up, everybody? This is for Private One, and today I want to update the glitch that allows you to one-shot most bosses and most enemies in Borderlands 3. Now, this is specifically going to be for Mohs. You do need a Legendary class mod for Mohs and the shield, so this is specifically for her. You're not going to be able to really do this on anybody else. So, the items you're going to need is the Bloodletter class mod, which when you basically what we're using it for is when you regenerate health, you also regenerate shields. And then we're using the Brawler Ward, which give you damage increases when your shields are depleted. And then you get health regen that doubles when your shields are depleted. And all of these will stack every time your shield is depleted. And since we have the Bloodletter class mod, all of that percentage regen that keeps stacking will also keep stacking for our shields as well, pretty much making us close to unkillable, depending on how much actual shields you can still technically one shot. But then you'll also be able to pretty much one shot most things in the game, bar bosses that go immune. Even if you do their full health bar in one shot, they'll still usually immune for that, so you won't be able to actually one shot them, but you'll be able to come as close to one shotting them as possible in the game. And what you're going to be doing is you're going to be going to the Splinterlands in Pandora. So you're going to be going to Pandora, you're going to be going to the Splinterlands, and then you're going to be going right where I am, right in this section right here. And once you get to the very end, you basically go up some stairs. There's only two enemies to fight in this area, so really you don't have to worry about anything. You're going to come up here, and it's going to be basically a roller coaster you can ride. Now you're going to go over to this electric fence over here, and go to this side right here, and you'll be able to actually electrocute yourself on it. Now, don't just stand in it when you first start. Oh, also, I don't have any skills spec'd. Make sure when you're doing this, don't have like any tanky skills spec'd, because especially for this one that gives you shock resistance, you won't be able to get as many stacks because you literally won't be able to deplete your shield anymore. So basically, you just walk into this. Now, when you don't have a lot of stacks, you're going to be hurt. So you want to let your health regen. My health is only regening to that much because a lot of it is reserved because of the class mod. One of the talents on the class mod it gives you. This class mod usually does roll that. So mostly everyone will have that anyway. But let your health regen up. It's mainly on the health because that's what's going to kill you right now. So basically you just keep walking in and out of this. Just make sure not to kill yourself. It's not really that hard. And once you start getting to a certain point, as you'll see, I'm getting a lot more regen. And once you start getting to a certain point, as you can see, if I would have just stood there, it would have killed me even at this point. But once you get to a certain point, pretty much right now, as you can see, it's not doing enough damage to actually kill me at any point, so I can just stand here. But then, as you'll see soon, at some point, this won't do enough damage to actually deplete my shield anymore. And as you can see, I'm still getting the effect, the sound of shield depletions. So once that stops, which it'll probably stop pretty soon here, once you get the effect stopping and the noise stopping right now, now it won't deplete. It can't fully deplete my shields anymore because of how much regen I have. It actually just can't deplete it. And I don't know of any other way to affect this, really, just because of how much regen we have. And the Brawler Ward pretty much rolls the same way every time. Maybe you could get like a lower level Brawler Ward or something if you want to do that. If you want to get more and more stacks, you might be able to do that with a lower level Brawler Ward and actually get more and more stacks. But doing this all at level 50, which getting the lower level ones would take a lot more time. Doing this all at level 50, this is pretty much the maximum amount of stacks you can get. Because if you're doing this like I was doing it before with like a cutter right here or a cutsman, right now if I shot the ground and shot myself, I'm pretty sure it would one-shot me through the almost 14k shields and 4k health. I'm pretty sure it would one-shot me just because of how high we actually stacked up this buff. So that's all you need to do. And now whenever you go fight something, you're gonna have pretty much instant regen unless you get one shot, but you're gonna have a ridiculous amount of damage. Now what I recommend for doing this, for one-shotting bosses, is using the deep dive face puncher. If you don't know what this weapon does, it basically shoots out your melee damage, I think in every pellet it's considered, but basically when you're shooting, it's increasing by your melee damage. I'm pretty sure it also does increase with just weapon damage. I'm not exactly certain how every different thing in the game affects it like that. I know some of Amara weapon damage stuff affects the deep dive phase puncher and some of it does not, so it's kind of weird. But basically this is going to do the highest damage you can get, because it's going to be getting pretty much 300% damage increase instead of 25% like all the other weapons get. So use a deep dive phase puncher. Other weapons are still going to be insane. If you're trying to one-shot bosses, use this. And you can also, past this point, you can fully respec. You can change everything, I'm pretty sure, besides the shield. I have changed class mods and it seems to still work, but I'm not certain if that will happen every time. So pretty much, I'd recommend just keeping on the class mod, keeping on the shield. And past this point, you can just go spec into whatever you want to, respec as many times as you want, fast travel to anywhere you want. If you go back to the main menu, this will deactivate pretty much every time. I think there's a chance it doesn't for whatever reason, but pretty much going back to the main menu, this will reset it. Restarting the game will reset it, but you can go anywhere you want. If you want to farm anything, you can put on you know, your different items, you can do whatever you want, and it should stay on. So that's pretty much the entire video. I'm going to have some footage of me trying to one-shot any boss and any things I possibly can. So subscribe if you want to see more Borderlands 3 content. Leave a like if you liked the video. Leave a comment down below what you think about the updated version of the one-shot glitch with the Brawl Award. And thanks for watching.
Dead.